Colorado State Forest is a 71,000-acre state trust property located in north-central Colorado. It runs approximately 30 miles along the west side of the Medicine Bow Mountains. And the elevations range from 8,000 feet to about 13,000 feet. The Colorado State Forest is a multiple-use property with many activities taking place, ranging from grazing, forestry, to recreation. The Colorado State Forest provides a range of resources, most notably its forest resource. The forests are comprised of Engelmann spruce and subalpine fir at the higher altitudes, and lodgepole pine and quaking aspen at the lower altitudes. The forest not only provides scenery, aesthetics, and a beautiful backdrop for the visitors to the state park, but it's also intrinsic to providing habitat, food for diverse wildlife species that include moose, elk, deer, bear, and numerous birds. Besides the native woodland inhabitants, cattle also graze on the forest through leases that supply revenue to the public trust for financial support of Colorado's public schools and other public institutions. The forests here also ensure a clean and dependable water supply downstream. Healthy forests naturally filter and store precipitation from rain and snow, keeping runoff water clear and regulating stream flow. In the Colorado State Forest, two entities are responsible for resource and recreation management. Colorado Parks and Wildlife manages the forest as a state park.
So Colorado Parks and Wildlife manages all the recreational opportunities in the park. That includes everything from active recreation to passive recreation. So active recreation would be things such as camping, hiking, hunting, fishing, OHV operations, snowmobiling, mountain biking, and then it spans into some of the things that might be considered more passive recreation, which would be like wildlife watching, bird watching, nature photography, those types of activities, just sitting and enjoying the outdoors.
Working alongside Parks and Wildlife, Colorado State Forest Service manages the forest resource. Forest management activities in the forest not only provide timber products from harvesting operations, but also improves overall forest health, improving the wildlife habitat, mitigating wildfire risk, and increasing safety for the visitors to the forest. Almost since its inception, grazing, recreation, and forestry have all coexisted on the state forest. An extensive timber harvesting program on the state forest was conducted from about 1940 to 1970. The program supported several large logging camps, including the Bachman Lumber Camp, the largest logging camp ever in Colorado history. Wood harvesting peaked in 1955 on the state forest, and the high level of harvesting at that time created some public controversy. By the mid-1960s, the lumber camps had started to close, and by 1970, the last of the lumber camps had closed. There are no longer permanent lumber camps on the state forest, but timber harvesting remains an important management tool for stewards of the land. The visual impacts of forest management, at least in the short term, can be obvious. It's important to the visitor to understand why the forest is managed. So why do we harvest timber on the state forest? One obvious example is the recent mountain pine beetle epidemic.
After the mountain pine beetle epidemic, we had all these dead trees. The only green areas were previous harvests. And now that we're cutting the trees, the dead trees around these previous harvests were really showing off the previous management and how good those harvests were, those small patch cuts were, because they're green, healthy forests. And we're actually coming back through and thinning some of those now to increase the health and keep them growing quickly.
Even without the threat of mountain pine beetle and other forest insects, active forest management, including timber harvesting, remains critical to the continued health of the Colorado State Forest. The Colorado State Forest Service management efforts on the state forest include timber harvesting, forest thinning, planting trees, and actions to reduce vegetative fuel buildup in the forest. These include wintertime burning of slash piles left behind by harvest operations. One key benefit of the removal of the timber is that it generates significant financial support for the Colorado State Trust, with most of the revenue going to public schools.
So we have a lease with the State Forest Service to manage that property. They do that to the extent possible to generate revenue. And as all of our revenue does, goes to benefit K through 12 education, essentially fund K through 12 education in the state.
Another reason that forest management by the Colorado State Forest is critical to the health of the state forest is the growing human presence on the landscape, including park visitors and homeowners living near the state forest boundaries. The Colorado State Forest Service also works with scientists to facilitate research on the state forest, investigating and informing forest management by focusing on such areas as the effects of mountain pine beetle on water yields and the feasibility of using lodgepole pine for bioenergy applications. Thanks to the careful and ongoing management of the forest resources at the Colorado State Forest, wildlife are abundant, recreation experiences are enhanced, watersheds are protected, and the risk of future large-scale bark beetle outbreaks is reduced. The ongoing forest management of the Colorado State Forest today ensures a healthy and productive state forest for many years to come for the benefit of future generations.